This is Tone Talks coming to you with a new project with theGrio, where we connect economics, race, and politics in a whole new and innovative way. So this is a case where Byron Allen Entertainment Studios have brought litigation against Charter and Comcast for basically shutting them out of business and contracting as a result of race. The Ninth Circuit pretty much agreed with Byron Allen, and what we have now is a case where the Supreme Court has decided to hear not the whole case, but essentially one part of the case involving Civil Rights Act of 1866 on behalf of Comcast. So we have Comcast actually bringing Byron Allen to the Supreme Court, a black man trying to do business, and we have to analyze this and ask ourselves, what are we gonna do and what are we gonna say about it? The Civil Rights Act of 1866 is really important because it is the law that introduced civil rights to America. It is the first Civil Rights Act. Essentially, it became law as a result of cheating, plundering, theft that was done to the newly freed slave. The slaves were freed in December of 65. By December of 66, we have the Civil Rights Act of 1866 over Andrew Johnson's veto, then president. And now what we have as a result of just all kind of missteps by Comcast and Charter, in my view, is an attempt to actually dwindle back or take back the ability to use this law to lead to fairness and equality. Eventually, the Civil Rights Act of 1866 went as far as to lead to the 14th Amendment, which is the first time we see the word equality in the Constitution. It actually led to what we now see as birthright citizenship in an attempt to create some sense of fairness and equality for the descendants of slavery, but not just them, also all Americans that are non-white. I think for a lot of us, that's kind of hard to digest because we want to digest and see this case as a Byron Allen lawsuit, a billionaire versus a behemoth Comcast company. Well, in a more specific sense, what you see right now is that the Supreme Court is going to decide on whether we use a but-for or a motivating factor standard for the Civil Rights Act of 1866. But-for standard will raise the bar so high on the Civil Rights Act of 1866 that you'll effectively need a smoking gun, basically a racial epithet, or some kind of letter that actually shows a direct attempt to use race to actually lead to you not getting a contract. That's very hard to prove if you don't have access to internal documentation or records of a company. Whereas the motivating factor standard allows a much more lenient kind of review, may even go as far as to allow you to look at the outcomes. And when we say outcomes, do you do business with black Americans or Asian Americans or Latino Americans? I think for a lot of us, what we need to understand is the importance of this moment. This moment is an important moment. When coupled with Citizens United, the tax cuts, and everything we've seen in recent years that has led to wealth inequality, what the Civil Rights Act of 1866 being pulled back can do is actually hyper-accelerate the inability for everyone to have access to America. Today, what I wanted to do is come to you and say, what I believe needs to happen is a massive national call to action, where African Americans, Latinos, Asians, everyone who is non-white that has been shut out of business gets a chance to say, you can't take away the Civil Rights Act of 1866. What we need to do with this law at this moment is demand that Comcast actually pull back and look at what the impact of their lawsuit can have on Civil Rights Act of 1866. I'd say that people should call in to Comcast and make their frustrations known. I also believe that people should even cut wire and believe that if Comcast is gonna attack all of our civil rights, they should get none of our dollars. People on Twitter have already taken this a step further, tweeting that they've already cut their Comcast, in addition that they've made calls and that they've voiced their frustrations. You should do the same. When we look at this thing, we can't help but understand that white America owns 90% of the wealth while black America owns 3%, despite being 14% of the population and having built America. That is not what was meant when the Civil Rights Act of 1866 was actually created. Because we haven't used this law properly, because this law is being pulled back, because of discrimination in the marketplace, what you see is an unfair America. Today is our chance to make sure that America is truly something all of us can access. Stay tuned, there's gonna be more videos coming to theGrio from Tone Talks discussing economics, race, politics, and how the three intertwine. Let's talk about it.